The University of Dhaka is the most reputed and the oldest center of excellence in Bangladesh. The world recognizes University of Dhaka as one of the institutions with highest academic quality globally. How did this institution evolve? When the Viceroy, Lord Hardinge, visited Dhaka in 1912, they met with Nawab Khaja Salimullah, Nawab Syed Nawab Ali Chaudhary, Sher-e Bangla A.K. Fazlul Haq, and many other Bengal Muslim leaders, and proposed to establish a university for the higher education of Bengal Muslims. A committee of 13 members was created and led by Robert Nathan in order to materialize the project of Dhaka University. The Dhaka University Ordinance 1920 was enacted. The Deputy Register of the University of London, Sir P.J. Hartog, was appointed as the Vice-Chancellor of Dhaka University. Then, in 1921, the University of Dhaka started its journey with three faculties, Arts, Science and Law, along with a few numbers of residential halls. At that time, the Dhaka University campus encompassed the Dhaka Medical College premises and a square mile area of Ramna Civil Line, including all the buildings and religious establishments in that area. At the very beginning, there were only 60 teachers, 877 male students and a single female student. The introductory phase, starting from 1921 to 1947, was considered as the glory days for the university. At that time, the excellence in the practice of education, research and knowledge brought Dhaka University the title of the Oxford of the East. One of the globally renowned faculties of University of Dhaka, Shuddhendranath Bose, first invented the idea of Higgs boson particle, which is the key to the creation of matter and the earth. The Bose-Einstein law is one of the major laws of today's physics education.
After the partition in 1947, the colleges here started to get affiliated with the University of Dhaka.
Let me make it very clear to you, leave no doubt that the state language of Pakistan is going to be Urdu and no other language.
In 1947, when the Governor General of Pakistan, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, proposed Urdu as the national language of Pakistan, it was the students of the University of Dhaka who broke into a protest immediately. Later, in 1948, many respected teachers, including Dr. Muhammad Shahidullah and Dr. Qazi Mutahar Hussain, tried to raise public opinion in favor of Bangla as the mother tongue. After a long period of struggle, came the language movement of 21st February 1952. The University of Dhaka led the movement, and it is the Amtala premises of Dhaka University where the agitated students broke into a dauntless protest for their mother tongue. Student leaders, along with Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, made the Sarbodoliyo Rashtrabhasha Sangram Parishad and declared its programs. Sheikh Mujibur Rahman was arrested in 15th February. From 16th February, he started a hunger strike along with other leaders who were also arrested. The historic procession of the movement for our mother tongue started right here by defying Section 144 imposed by the autocrats. Even in the middle of such disturbance, the academic curriculums of the university were never interrupted. After 1961, quite a number of faculties and departments were established. New residential halls were constructed, including the International P.J. Hartog Hall. The first residential hall for female students was established in 1963 and named after Begum Rukaya, the forerunner of Muslim women empowerment. At this period, our renowned arts building, along with some new institutes, was established. TSC, the Teachers Student Center, the much-loved hub of the university, was built at that time. In 1966, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman was again arrested for declaring the six-point movement under the Agartala conspiracy. But the youthful people and the students freed him from prison. In 1969, the leaders of Dhaka University Central Students Union honored Sheikh Mujibur Rahman with the title of Bangabandhu in a grand reception. In 1971, under the call of the father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the people of East Pakistan hosted the Bangladesh flag for the first time in the Dhaka University campus. The students gathered together in the campus area for the liberation war with dummy rifles in hands. The barbaric Pakistani soldiers picked numerous places as their targets for violence, and the University of Dhaka was one of those prime targets. Within a single night, almost 300 people, including 10 university teachers and 26 employees, were brutally murdered. Mass killing took place at the different residential halls of the University of Dhaka. Under the horrid conspiracy of the Pakistani government, the Rajakar al-Badars killed some of the valued scholars of our university, including Govinda Chandra Dev, Ghiyasuddin Ahmed, Shahidullah Kaisar, Jyotirmoy Guha Thakurata, and many others. The University of Dhaka has never forgotten its esteemed teachers. Some of the residential halls are named after them to show respect and keep them in our memory.
After the liberation in 1973, the teachers were honored with utmost respect, and the three-year honors final exam system was changed into the yearly course system. Later, the semester system was introduced. Also, in the case of script evaluation, the first, second, third division system was forgone and the grading system was adopted. Shilpa Chaudhary Jainul Abidin's dream, the Institute of Fine Arts, popularly known as Charukola, became a full-fledged faculty of the university. Many fine arts departments were established there according to international standards. As time passed by after the liberation war, some new residential halls were built for the students and the teachers, aside from extending the old residential ones. Because of the contribution the Nawabs of Dhaka had in the creation of the University of Dhaka, the Nawab Nawab Ali Chaudhary Sinet building was built as a token of gratitude towards them. To keep the undying and eternal memory of the liberation war evergreen in the heart of the nation, a sculpture of Oparajeya Bangla is built in the facade of the arts building of the university. In the courtyard of the central mosque of this university lie the cemeteries of the national poet Qazi Nazrul Islam and the great artist Jainul Abidin.
Among the educational institutes of Bangladesh, the University of Dhaka is claimed to be of the highest echelon. The university has expanded gradually with time. It is moving forward with several departments, faculties, institutes, research centers, and bureaus of arts, commerce, science, law, engineering, and technology, medical sciences in its academic programs. The number of teachers of the university has exceeded 1,800, and there are almost 34,000 students in the university currently. There is a library of international standard in the university. The library is ornated with many valuable books, journals, and magazines. For the science students of the university, there are modern equipments and advanced research laboratories facilitated in the different faculties of science. There exists a separate library for only the science students of the university. There are a number of playgrounds, a swimming pool and an excellent gymnasium available in the university. The contribution of the University of Dhaka in the cultural aspects of the country is also unparalleled. The university celebrates all cultural festivals including the Spring Festival and the first day of the Bangla New Year. The University of Dhaka also leads in celebrating the International Mother Language Day on the 21st of February every year. Many world-renowned people have privileged the University of Dhaka with their presence. Among them are world-famous novelist Sharadchandra Chattopadhyay, Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore, and scientist Jagadish Chandra Bosu are mentionable. The University of Dhaka has conferred honorary doctoral degrees to a number of famous personalities of the world, including Ban Ki-moon, Pascal Lamy, Nobel laureate Amartya Sen, the Honorable Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina.
পৃথিবীর অনেক দেশ আমাকে এর আগে সম্মানসূচক ডক্টরেট ডিগ্রি প্রদান করলেও আজকের এই সম্মান আমার পরম আনন্দের, আমার জীবনের দুর্লভ সঞ্চয়ের ও গৌরবের অর্জন, কারণ
Faculty of Business Studies, leading faculty of the University of Dhaka. It ensures excellence both in the fields of academic and co-curricular activities. It has the most preeminent and dexterous faculties, as well as it provides the best learning facilities for the business students. Faculty of Business Studies has 5 programs. 6,092 students, 8 departments, 8 labs, 1 bureau of research, 10 officers and 58 employees. The faculty premises is well ornated and eye-soothing with academic and administrative buildings, state-of-the-art classrooms, computer labs, business research institute and international standard food court. The Faculty of Business Studies, in order to give the students practical knowledge about business and corporate world, arranges different workshops, seminars, trainings, campus recruitment and job fair, study tours on a regular basis. Students of this faculty have participated in various international competitions and proved their capability by defeating competitors from the world's most reputed universities, including Harvard, Cambridge, and MIT, and many more. We celebrate all the national and cultural significant days like Independence Day, Victory Day, First Day of the Bengali New Year, popularly known as Pohila Boishakh, First Day of Spring, popularly known as Pohila Falgun. Faculty of Business Studies has always responded to the call of humanity. Faculty always distributes winter clothes to the poor people in winter-inflicted areas of Bangladesh. In 2013, the faculty has stood by the victims of Rana Plaza accident with financial and non-financial assistance. The University of Dhaka is not only an educational institute of the country today, it has also become an inseparable piece of the dignified history of our nation. In 2021, when the whole country will be celebrating the Golden Jubilee of our independence, the University of Dhaka will be receiving the great and rare honor of completing a glorious 100 years. We are proud of this great institution, the Oxford of the East. Long live Dhaka University, long live Bangladesh.